Hey everybody, welcome back to Run and Gun. I'm JT, and in this video, I'm giving you my top neon portrait tips and tricks. So watch until the very end because you're not gonna wanna miss a single one. Let's get right into it. My first neon portrait tip is to use complementary colors. Now, if you're familiar with the color wheel, that means opposite colors on the color wheel, like purple and yellow, red and green. In this case, I'm using a blue and a pink, which are very close to being opposite on the color wheel, and it gives a cool kind of outrun vaporwave 80s vibe. So use complementary colors for some great color contrast in your portraits. My second tip for taking awesome neon portraits is to avoid yellow neon signs. I'm not quite sure what it is, but that little bit of warmth kind of messes with your white balance and it never looks quite right. So I just like to avoid yellow neon signs altogether. Tip number three for taking neon portraits, and this is very good general portrait advice, always expose for your subject. There's a lot of people I see that like to shoot 5 stops underexposed so that they can get all of their highlight data, and then they end up just blowing their highlights out in Lightroom anyway. Don't do that, you're gonna have to bring up a lot of noise. Expose for your subject. Your subject is the most important thing in your photograph, so you always wanna expose for your subject. Now, I'm not saying you can't underexpose by maybe a stop or two, but anything more is really pushing it. So be sure to expose for the most important part of your photograph, and that is your subject. Tip number four is to try and not clip your highlights and have your highlights way too overexposed in relation to your subject. Now, you're probably thinking that just goes against the advice I just gave you of not underexposing. If there's such a difference between your light and your subject, that means you probably have to throw a little bit more light on your subject. One way to fix this is to introduce some artificial lighting into your scene. Maybe some speed lights, a flashlight, a strobe, or some additional LED lights to help expose your subject properly and not lose those clipped highlights. Tip number five, and surprisingly, a lot of portrait photographers don't know this, when your eyes are in focus, your subject is in focus. If your eyes of your subject are out of focus, that means your whole photograph is out of focus. Your subject is the most important thing in your scene. For example, if you're shooting a model, and if her eyes or his eyes are out of focus, your whole scene is technically out of focus because that is the most important thing. So take that extra second, make sure your image is properly composed, and make sure those eyes are in focus. Tip number six for taking great neon portraits is a post-processing tip, and that is to not kill your highlights. One of the biggest mistakes I see photographers make in post-processing is to take that highlight slider and slide it all the way to -100, usually as the first thing they do, and you don't want to do that. Your highlights are where all of your glow is at. As soon as you start cranking down your highlights, you actually start losing glow from your images, and you don't want to do that. You're also going to make your image look really bad, and it's really going to look like you just dragged your highlights all the way down, probably in an attempt to save your clipped highlights. So that's again why I brought up the tip earlier. Try not to clip your highlights, and then you won't have to crank them all the way down. You can usually drop your highlights in Lightroom or Photoshop to -10, -15, and still get away with it, but you really don't want to mess with your highlights that much because, again, that is where all the data from your glow is at, and that is the coolest part about neon portraits. Tip number seven for awesome neon portraits is interaction. The closer you can get your subject to your lights, the cooler your image is gonna look. If you can have your model interact with your light and get some great lighting on their face, their hands, do something unique within the scene just to get that light to work with your subject, that is gonna make your portrait more unique, and it's gonna tie the light to your subject, and it's gonna make your portrait better rather than just having someone blandly stand in front of a neon sign. My next neon portrait tip is to pay particular attention to your shutter speed. If you shoot too fast of a shutter speed, you will be shooting faster than the sync rate or the refresh rate of the neon sign itself, and you will see lots of dark bands, or you will see a lot of flickering on the face of your model, and that will show up as these very dark bands across your image and essentially ruin your photograph. So I recommend using a shutter speed of 1/125th of a second or lower, so you're not getting that flickering or banding. If you need to, prop yourself up against a wall, bring a monopod, bring a tripod to make sure your shot is stable, but don't use a ridiculously fast shutter speed. Also, make sure you're pressing your shutter button properly to avoid introducing extra camera shake into your image. And you can check out my video for how to properly press your shutter button up here and down in the description. Tip number 9 is another post-processing tip. Don't over-edit your neon portraits. The more natural you leave your photo, honestly, the better it looks. The first thing people are tempted to do is drag their highlights, negative 100, shadows, plus 100, turn that clarity up all the way, turn that dehaze all the way, and then noise reduction to 100, and you're left with a pretty crappy looking image. Don't over-process. Let the image speak for itself. Tip number 10 for taking neon portraits is to use fast prime lenses. Those lenses will allow you to really open up your aperture, get a lot more light to your sensor, and get all of that neon light into your image. Fast primes will also give you very shallow depth of field, some nice bokeh maybe of streetlights in the background, and really add that extra little something to your images. When you're using those fast primes with an aperture of 1.2, 1.4, 1.8, or even 2, you're letting so much more light into your sensor without having to crank up your ISO to 1250, 12,000, 25,000, and introducing a whole bunch of noise into your portrait. One last bonus tip for taking great neon portraits is to use what I call the portrait lens trifecta, and that is going to be your 85 millimeter lens, 50 millimeter lens, and a 35 millimeter prime. If you can get those lenses on a 1.4 or 1.8, that's going to be awesome for neon portraits. Your 35 millimeter is going to allow you to get those wider full body shots, whether from the feet to the head or the knees to the head. Your 50 millimeter is going to have slightly more compressed foreground and background, a little more bokeh, and it's going to allow you to get those very nice shallow depth of field shots, probably from the top of the head to the middle of the chest. And then that 85 millimeter prime is going to be for those very nice tight shots, lots of bokeh, very shallow depth of field, amazing for portraits. And you can even do, if you wanted to, a full body with an 85 millimeter lens and just get that razor thin depth of field. So those are my tips that I use on every single neon portrait shoot. Get out and give them a try. If you like this video and you learned something, be sure to give it a thumbs up, share it with a photography friend, and as always, subscribe for more run and gun tips and tricks. And until next weekend, get out and go shoot.